Hi guys, in this tutorial we will be discussing about multi-dimensional arrays and how they are stored in memory. Okay, so let me first discuss about 2D array. So a 2D array is simply how to declare first of all a 2D array int m cross n, where m is the number of rows and n is the number of columns. Okay, so this is how you define. So it's quite easy to understand that m rows means 0, 1, 2 up to m minus 1, there will be this many rows, and 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n minus 1 columns. So total n columns and m rows. Okay, so this is how a 2D matrix looks like, 2D array looks like. Now what? This is how you declare it. Now how you store a 2D array in memory? Okay, that's quite important. So say I have a matrix A 2 cross 3, so there are 2 rows and 3 columns in it. Okay, and I'm storing 1 2 3 4 5 6 in it, and since this is A, I know that A is the pointer to the base address of the array, so this is the pointer A. This is 0, 1, 2, 0, 1. So what this is? This is A, 0, 0. Then this will be A, 0, 1. This is A, 0, 2. This is A, 1, 0. 1th row, 0th column. A, 1, 1. A, 1, 2. You got the idea? How these are numbered? Now, let us talk about the addressing. Since all the elements are integers here, if this is the base address is 100, then next element will be, if it's 4 bytes integer, 104, this is 108. So you know that 444, 12 bytes are consumed by first line. So the next address will be starting from 112. Okay, then this is 116 and this is 120. Okay, so this is how the addressing is done. Now this is not the actual way it is stored, or you can see that we are storing it like this. First is 100, so at 100 we are storing A00, then A01, then A02, then that was 108, and from 112 we are storing A10, then A12, then A11 and A12. Okay, so what is the idea here is that we by default are following a special way to store a 2D array in memory. That's called row major order. So in this order we first store, because a memory is considered as a 1D tape. Okay, you store it in a consecutive fashion, because this is array anyhow, we have to store in consecutive way only. So either row is completely stored first, first row is completely stored, then second row is completely stored, then third row is completely stored, or first column is completely stored, then second column is completely stored, then third column is completely stored. The second way is called column major order. The first way which we are following here is called row major order. So let us discuss first the two ways to store 2D array in memory. First one is called row major order. So in row major order, if you have a if you have an array 0 1 2 0 1 2, what you will do, you will first take this line and you will store it in this tape. Then you will, this is row 1, call it row 0. Then you will take the second row as row 1. Then you will take the third row as row 2. Okay, this is how you store in row major order. And how you store in column major order? You just take the same, but in tape of memory, what you store first is this first column, column 0. Then this column, that is column 1, then this column, that is column 2. So this is how you store in column measure order. So now let us discuss how to find any element in such scenario. So in first case, that is the row measure order, let me use a different color. If I have a declaration of my array is m n and I want to access a I j while it is row measure order, how will I define? So understand one thing, that if this is an array 0 1 2 0 1 2 3, if this is an array A, what you will do if you want to find the location of A 2 3, so what normally do you do? You go this location, okay, A 2 3 is this location, but how will you reach them? So A 2 means, for now you understand that this means that this many lines are skipped. So 0 1 that is 2, 1 2 two lines are skipped, 3 means 3 columns are skipped, 1 2 3. So when you skip 2 lines, you will get this line, and when you skip 3 columns, 1 2 3, you will get this column. Okay, so by skipping means that I am going to the address part. When you skip 2 lines, I will come at this base address of the third line. When I skip 3 columns, I will be at the base address of fourth column. Okay, so this is the basic idea which we generalize here. So if I want to get the location or the base address of Aij, first of all, every array has a base address. Okay, so if I want to find the address of Aij, what I will do is I will have a base address of the complete array, okay, in which I will be adding this many lines, because these many lines are already skipped, right? So this multiplied by, and if I am skipping these many lines, so how many bytes is consumed by each such line? That will be given by the number of elements in each line into the size of each element, right? So how many elements, number of elements is given by n, okay, and each such element is having some size, that is given as size. So you got the idea, right? These many lines, in each line there are these many elements of these many bytes. So this is the number of bytes which is to be added to come where? To come here. Because what you are doing is you are skipping, say, 1 2 3, here 3 lines. So I equals to 3, if I want to access A 3 3, then I have to skip this many lines. So I am skipping this line and this line. So I skipped, so I came here, and in this skipping, how many bytes did I skip? I skipped 3 lines, into each line has 4 elements and each element has 4 bytes, because it is each is integer. So what did I do? I just did, this is my I, this is my n, number of elements in each line, and the size of each element is 4. Okay, so this is how I am doing. So what I did, I just got the base address. I'm just standing right now here, but I want the location of this point. For that I have to shift by k. K is what? I have to shift by J. J is what? The column. So I have to skip that many columns. So that is given by J. Okay. So this is how you compute the base address of an element in row measure order. Now the same thing. Okay. This is again to be because I have to multiply by size. Okay, so this was the base address, say this was 100, and this many lines are already skipped. So this is the bytes which are skipped, and now this is the number of column. Okay, so column into size will give the number of bytes to be reached to the final location. Okay, now this is the row measure order which is done. Second is column measure order. Column measure order. Okay, now how it is done? In column measure order, this is 0 1 2 0 1 2 3. What you do, you store column 0 first, then column 1, then column 2. How many columns? 4 columns. Then column 3. Okay, so what does it mean? And say this is the array int a mn, and I want to find the address of aij here. So I know now that if I want to access this, or say this element, if I want to access this element, how many columns do I have to skip? First this column, then this column. So how many? 2 columns. So if I want to go to here, that is A22, or let's make it A23, this column. So that will be A23. If I want to access A23, what I have to do, I have to skip this many columns. Why? Because I am storing in row column measure. So this column will be stored first, then this column, then this column. So skip that many column. So I am just skipping this column, then this column, then this column. Okay, so I had skipped this many columns. So how many elements did I skipped? Did I skip? I skipped 3 cross in each row, in each column. How many in each column how many rows are there? You just need to compute that. So that will be given by this. In each column, this many rows are there. So this. And what is the size of each element? Just this. So you got the idea that you just skip these many columns. In each column, how many rows? These many rows, or these many elements. And this is the size. So each column, how many elements? M1, 2, 3. So 3 is the size of rows, or in each column you have this many elements in your column. So this is how you compute to go to base address of this column. Now you are at here. This is first column, second column, third column. You skip this many part. Now you are here. So for going to this part, you have to skip by your I is 2 here. So first row, second row, skip that. Skip 2 elements. So 2 elements means 2 cross 4. Okay, so you just got the idea how it is being done. So for computing the address of aij in column measure order, what you need to do is add the base address. Just add the base address plus what is to be added. How, what you are skipping here is for aij, what you are skipping, we are skipping j into each element, each column having m elements in it, and the size of each element. So you got at this point now. And now to skip these many rows, that is given by I into size of each element. What you got? You got the base address of aij in column measure order. Okay, I guess that's quite clear. And in this part, I guess the three-dimensional, okay, that's also quite easy. And the same concepts which are applied on 2D array can be applied on 3D array also. 3D array, and that can be extended to 4D array or ND array also. So what 3D array is, like 2D array, this is a 2D array. In 3D array, you will be defining int a m n p. So this is your m and n, and then for p you have to define the m and n again. If p equals to 2, this is p equals to 0, this is p equals to 1. This is quite easy idea, but hopefully we will discuss it in next lecture. Thanks.